Every kid wants to win an NBA championship. You see the bottom. The bottom has been for multiple years. And I'm waiting on this moment right here.
That's my game. Straight up, 16 years of this.
This is it, and this really is it. This is the last 7 games.
For Giannis when he took the court for the first time in his career in an NBA Finals, but it's great to know that Giannis will be playing after missing the last 2 games with a hyper-extended knee. Now, also fun fact, let's talk about some homegrown talent that we're going to see in this year's NBA Finals, because Giannis and Devin Booker are both homegrown stars, and they're making this the first Finals matchup since 2010 where the leading scorer on each team has not played for another franchise. Now, in that series, it was Kobe Bryant and Uncle P, Paul Pierce. Now, another homegrown player for the Suns is DeAndre Ayton, who has shot 50% or better in all 16 playoff games. Jay Will was just trying to tell you, it's the second longest streak within a single postseason trailing Shaq in 2006. And Ayton has formed a strong partnership with Chris Paul, who has had quite a journey to the finals. 5 different teams, 16 seasons, 123 playoff games, but Paul finally got to this stage, and it's by no mistake, because he had to put in the work in Game 6 against the Clippers.
Absolutely. How about the fact that he scored 19 points by himself in the fourth quarter, and the entire Clippers team scored 20?
Wow.
You want more? In the fourth quarter of the last series, Chris Paul, 27 assists, Jay Will. Only 1 turnover. Stats will never define his greatness, because in the regular season, he doesn't put up those gaudy type numbers. But I tell you what, his leadership and his productivity has been outstanding.
And Jalen, you know, what the Bucks really want to see happen, even with Giannis coming back, is they want to continue to see Drew Holiday be really aggressive, even with Giannis on the floor. He's had 8 points more per possession, over 100 possessions with Giannis off the floor. But they want to see Holiday not defer, and they're going to need him here in this series. Remember, the last time the Bucks traded for a big guard in the offseason, 1970, they traded for Oscar Robertson, won a championship. They hope that Holiday is the final piece to a title this year.
And Holiday,
yep.
A bigger guard, 6'3", 6'4", if you use that size to try to, you know, demean a little bit Chris Paul and hinder where he is on the floor. Look, for me, this game obviously comes down to Giannis, but it also comes down to Coach Bud. Throughout each playoff series, a lot of people have questioned, including myself, the adjustments in-game by Coach Budenholzer. Seeing what kind of adjustments he'll make with Giannis throughout the course of the game, seeing how defensively they will match up, will determine whether the Bucks win or lose this
game. Okay, y'all broke down the matchups. Now you know what time it is.
Oh, I hate this time.
Gotta make a pick. I'm sorry.
To win the game or the series?
The game!
Okay.
I'm going with the Phoenix Suns in this home crowd.
I think the Bucks get the first one.
All right. Well, on the other side of the break, you will get to the broadcast crew in game 1 of the NBA Finals. We'll see you at halftime.